What's going on, boys and girls? Welcome back to Feeky Flips, the most dumbed down real estate channel on all of YouTube, because if I can make money doing this, then so can you. We are here today about to walk this beauty right here. This is a fire damaged home here in Reno, and kind of a funny story on this one. You know, my homie Vlad from Vegas just locked this up yesterday, I believe. He's from Plot Property Group. You guys can check him out on Instagram. And since he's down in Vegas and we're here in Reno, he hit me up just to do some boots on the ground work for him. So I'm gonna grab some photos and some videos for him and then maybe help him with the dispo process to wholesale this thing. But other than that, you know, it's kind of funny because I was digging through my email. Actually, someone else had this locked up, I don't know, a few months ago. And I was looking at it and I actually saw this lead 3 years ago now when the fire actually happened. And my partner Wes, one of his buddies lived, I don't know if he's still there, but right next door. And when it was on the news for the fire, his buddy was actually on the news in his underwear out in the street. So I'll drop the news clip after we do the walkthrough here towards the end of the video. But super funny. But after the previous wholesaler had this locked up, they were trying to sell it for way too much. They were marketing it for like $300,000. And I think ARV on a good day right now is like $350,000. And obviously it has a lot of damage. And yeah, forgot what I was gonna say. Hold on one second. Hold that thought. Seller's here. I'll be right back.
Fucking with me, man. He man, ski man, spending next week's cash. He fast, and I don't even need a G-Pass. I'm past that. I'm passing them out now, and you can't have that. Hit my chain, too, can't Sam that. Tropical colors, you can't match that. Gotta be abstract. You catch my girl, legs open, better smash that. Don't be surprised if she asks where the cash at. I see she wearing them jeans, that's on her butt crack. My girls can't wear that. Why? That's where my stash at. I put my mat. Down.
Good timing on the seller pulling up, because as I was filming in the car, I forgot what the fuck I was talking about, and I was just staring at the camera blankly for like 30 seconds trying to remember. Then the owner pulled up, so good timing there. So now that you guys have seen the inside, pretty rough where Vlad has this locked up. Kind of doubtful that it's a deal just because of the amount of work that this thing needs. If you guys remember on the channel, this was a while ago, our college rental that we rent out by the room is in a very similar neighborhood, just on the other side of a major street here. But these two neighborhoods were built at the same time. Typically that neighborhood over there is a little bit more valuable just because it's closer to the school. So it has a lot more college kids than this one over here. But this house is super, super similar. This one actually has a pitched roof, not a flat one, which is nice. They installed trusses over top of the flat roof. But as you guys saw in there, I mean, it needs everything. And that's actually pretty similar to what our college rental looked like at that time, because although ours wasn't fire damaged, it was completely fucking destroyed when we bought it. And we had to take it down to the studs anyway. So this one, fire rehabs are super, super hard to estimate because you just don't know unless you're like specialized in that. And even like a contractor walking it, a lot of times they're gonna be guessing as well on rehab. What I do know is that on our rental, we spent $190,000 in rehab. And again, that was taking it down to the studs. We rearranged the floor plan. We added a bathroom. We did double appliances throughout. Like, we did fucking everything. So for this one, I think you could probably do it for about $120,000. It just kind of depends, because this thing is weird. As you guys saw in there, there's like weird ass additions on the back. Like, the entire back of the house is an addition, and it's like walled off, so there's not even access to one side of it. It looks like they used to have a door in there, but it's just a weird floor plan, and really it's kind of hard to count. And I was rushed because the sellers had to go somewhere, so I didn't even get to shoot the Matterport like I wanted to. But it's kind of hard to tell when it's just down to the studs. But I could definitely see like living room, kitchen, garage conversion, two bedrooms, bathroom, and then just huge area, like half the house is a conversion off the back. So now that it's down to the studs, now would be the time to rearrange the floor plan and make the best usage of the 1,700 square feet total that it is, which is really large for this neighborhood. Unfortunately, it's on a slab. So to do that, it's going to be pretty expensive because you got to cut up the concrete to move around the plumbing and all that stuff. So you could easily spend $150,000 in here, if not more, maybe get away with doing it for like $120,000. Really, really tough to tell. And then, you know, by the time you're done with it, you're still left with, you know, a $350,000, $370,000 single family home in a declining market. So we'll see what happens there. But now that you guys have seen the inside of the house, let's roll the tape on the news clip.
Access the inside from there, and they were able to successfully get inside the home by doing that. They were able to knock the fire out and limit the damage to the bedroom where the fire originated.
Yeah, when and I just remembered what I was going to say when I was blankly staring at the camera for 3 minutes before the seller showed up. I was going to say, you know, when the first wholesaler had this thing under contract, they were marketing it for way too high. I told them that. They got a huge price reduction and then were marketing it at like still probably not a deal level, obviously, or someone would have bought it. After enough time had passed when I knew that they wouldn't be in contract anymore, I had Kyle, our acquisition manager, I was like, put this one into the system, see if you can reach a seller. We skip traced the number and we could never reach them. So I'll have to ask Vlad how he ended up getting in contact. But I feel kind of fucking stupid now because driving past this house, there's a for sale by owner sign on it with the phone number. So like we could have just driven over here and called the seller. Their phone number was on the side of the house. So I guess that would be a lesson learned there. We can always check for something weird like that. But kind of funny. Sellers were super nice. I was chatting up the older guy about motorcycles here because we got some strays rolling up. But there's a motorcycle over here. And he was like, if that thing's on my side, you and me are going to roll it over, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, all right, anyway. So he said he's trying to get a 250 for him and his wife. He's like super old. He's like, I'll be, I can hold it up. And I was going to tell him to get a trike or something, even though I'm not a fan of trikes, but might be an option for him. But yeah, either way, we'll see if we can make this one work or if Vlad can get a price reduction to make it work, and hopefully we can dispo it for him. But thanks for watching. Make sure to smash that like button. Help us out with the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe if you're new here. Check out the podcast that we're dropping weekly. It's called Eating Shit. You can find it here on the channel or on the podcast apps, Spotify, wherever you listen to podcasts. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next episode.